There has been a real slump in crypto land recently. Prices are not going the direction that we all expected and wanted them to go in the new year. They mostly went south. And in this little video, I'll go through why that is, what's happening with Bitcoin, Ethereum, and Solana. Those are the three things that I mostly dive into in this little video. And let's analyze a little bit on why prices are going that direction and what direction they will likely go in the future, so that you can make your decision if you want to buy the dip, which is always great advice, right? Or if you want to, you know, just wait and see, or even sell, right? So that's what this video is about, so stay with me all the way to the end, and let's dive just right into it. So here we see the three-month chart for Solana, but let's get started with the three-month chart for Bitcoin, right? So we had that famous approval, SEC approval of the Bitcoin spot ETFs. And the largest ETF was just the Grayscale that was already there before. It was just not a spot ETF. What it was before was a trust, right? So there's a difference there, and the spot ETF is way better for compliance and stuff like that. And it opens the way for so many other investors, like pension funds and stuff like that. And it enables you to get it into your IRA or Roth IRA or whatever, right? So the spot ETF is great, but it didn't have the effect on the Bitcoin price that we expected, right? So the approval was somewhere here. There was a little bit of an uptick, but then it all went down, right? And in general, this is a 3 month chart. So we were at like 34 something 3 months ago. And then, you know, the high watermark here is around 46, 47. So that's not even a 50% gain here, right? And most of that has already been melted off here. So let's look at Ethereum in comparison, right? 3 months ago, we were at like 1800 and then it went up to 2600, right? So still 180 would be 10%. So yeah, it's like maybe 80% or so that it went up to this little maximum here. But it's also falling down like crazy here, and it's back to 2,220. So now let's look at Solana. Solana was only 3 months ago, guys, and it was around $30, right? And it went up to 121. I remember it was 125 for a little bit, just the day before Christmas. And then it lost steam a little bit, but not as much as the others. And see here, you know, recently there's just a small rally here, and it came up from 78 all the way to 87. And, you know, 125 from this 30 here, right? So that's like a 4x, right? More than a 4x. That's more than 300%. So it was by far the most gains here. And usually, you know, who gains the most loses the most when the direction changes. But it seems like Solana is not the one that's losing the most these days, right? And there's lots of movement in there. There's lots of volatility is always great, because when things go down, it gives us an opportunity to buy the dip, right? So would you buy the dip? And again, this is not financial advice. I'm not a financial advisor. This is just for entertainment purposes and to let me know what my personal opinion is. Your situation might be completely different, so better ask your financial advisor, tax advisor, whatever. But if we look at this here, right, I want to give you a little bit of thoughts on why that is and you know, what it means for the future. And the reason is I don't want to let you guys out there in the rain, right? So someone liked this thing, so I'll do it again. But I want you more to feel like this, right? So we all want to be happy and celebrate some nice gains. All right, so how do we do that? First of all, let's think, why is the Bitcoin price so low? And as you all know, Bitcoin is kind of the leader of the pack. It's still the cryptocurrency with the highest market cap by far. And, you know, altcoin prices and, you know, just crypto prices in general tend to follow a Bitcoin's lead, right? So with Bitcoin, we had high hopes with the ETF. What happened is the largest ETF by far, the one with like 20 billion in assets under management, the Grayscale ETF, it was just converted from the old trust that was already there. And seems like the FTX estate had lots of interest and lots of shares of that trust, that Grayscale trust. And now that it's an ETF, it's way easier for them to sell them off. And they sold off about $1 billion of Bitcoin, Grayscale, BTC-ETF shares in the last few days. And that is all there is, right? So the selling pressure should fade a little bit now. But still, we don't see the Bitcoin price going up again. There's going to be the halving. The halving should have, you know, a nice effect for a positive effect for Bitcoin prices as well. And but right now there was that selling pressure, and also there was that big run towards the end of last year, the December. It was a big run, especially for Solana and some other altcoins. So the old saying goes, what goes up must come down. And there's a lot of people that just take profits, right? And I think that's great, but otherwise, everything's still intact. The BTC story is still intact. The altcoin story, and especially the Solana story, is still intact. There's so many exciting developments going on the Solana front. And so that's the reason I'm definitely buying the dip. And obviously, you know, if you already bought the dip like a long time ago and it didn't happen, then you might have run out of cash. So that's kind of the art in investing, right? Always keep some amount of cash on the side to be able to buy the dip if there's a great opportunity. And even if you don't have that much cash on the sidelines, just buy a little bit of the dip, right? So I would say it's a great opportunity right now to buy some Sol. As you all know, I'm a big Solana fan. I think it's a great blockchain, and you know, it's the only blockchain that really works, and that can be the basis for Web3 and a real Cambrian explosion of Web3 dApps, especially with some new innovations that are out there. For example, the Jito MEV client, or the Xandeum, scalable storage layer that we're building. So I'm the CEO and founder of Xandeum. If you haven't heard of it, link is in the description, xandeum.com, and join everything that's on there, right? So let's have a look at xandeum.com. But before I go there, please don't forget to hit that like button if you like information like this that I'm giving you. Don't forget to leave me a comment. I want to discuss with you, how do you think crypto prices will be going? And what do you think, right? So, but for now, let's go back to to our own homepage, which is Xandeum.com. And when you go there, there's a lot of options here. You can read about everything here. You can read our light paper. You can read the technical white paper, the roadmap. So there's lots of resources here. We have a blog. We run our own Solana validator. There's news, careers, team. Everyone's doxed here. And there's a nice merch store. So please do buy our merch. It's awesome. And here you can join our Discord. I recommend that. It's a chat server, so you can just join there and chat with us in real time. You can subscribe to our email list. You can subscribe to our Twitter. Please do all that. And if you have some Sol, don't leave money on the table. Stake your Sol and stake here. You can stake to the Xandeum Solana validator and get like over 8%, 8.35% in APY on your Sol that you own, right? Don't leave that money on the table. So I hope you enjoyed this little video. Thanks for watching and catch you guys later. Bye.